the FT25BH. What we're showing here is both a red and a blue light set at a similar teach distance and triggering on and off. As we move that solid object towards the sensors, the red light has a small blind zone, whereas the blue light sensor stays triggered continuously throughout that movement. If we take a transparent object now and place it in front of both of these sensors, once again we can see both sensors trigger about the same time as we move the product in front. Once we give any kind of angle to this, however, the red light immediately does not detect the product, whereas the blue light stays on continuously, even at a really acute angle. This is really impressive for a diffuse sensor working in this scenario. Once again, if we move that close to the sensor, we see the blind spot of the red light versus the blue light being able to detect that continuously. If we move over to a cup and its cylindrical shape, as we move this cup relatively quickly in front of the sensor, we can see actually it looks like both red and blue are doing a similar job. A single trigger, it comes on as the cup moves in front. As we move this slower, we can actually see that the blue light comes on much earlier and stays on much later. That idea of seeing the much sharper angles allows this blue light to see much more of this cup, allowing it to detect it earlier and stay on longer as the cup's in front of that sensor. Fantastic in a packaging or a bottling scenario within the industry. If we now look at a cup with some shape to it, a logo on it, some differences in thickness to the plastic, we see the blue light handles it perfectly again, one trigger as the cup moves in front, whereas the red light is now giving 3, 4, maybe 5 triggers as it goes through. This would really ruin a counting application or being able to stop this cup in place when moving along the conveyor belt. I hope you found this information useful, and please reach out if you need any help